buy much, I buy land, bro. Cologne, Germany. Full McDonald's every time I land, bro. Big J rocks in both hands, bro, and all that.
Alright. That's it. I'm really excited about this new single from Baby Keem and Kendrick Lamar called The Hillbillies. So they're already doing some pretty good numbers. Like I said, new single. And hopefully kind of hints at, I don't know, maybe a new Baby Keem album this summer. Would be really, really cool. That would be great for not only his career, which is what matters, but also the fans. I think we'd really appreciate that. First of all, the production, very Jersey Club-ish, which is really fun, really exciting, as we saw that the masses really appreciated that sound with the recent popularization of it with Just Wanna Rock by Lil Uzi Vert. And also some other tracks recently, like Sticky off of Drake's Honest In Her Mind record, which was my favorite off of that record by far. You know, just kind of that boom, 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 boom kick pattern with like the stuttered, the you know, kind of UK drill or the Jersey Club hi-hat pattern, sequence, whatever you want to call it. Yeah, long story short, I really like this record. I've listened to it a lot already today. One thing that's really cool about this release is they released it through video on YouTube. It's not on streaming platforms as far as I know. I feel like everything I say should have that as a footnote really behind. Sorry, nice Porsche Panamera just drove by. Anyways, really great record. Played it loud as I was kind of running some errands earlier. And got some nice pedestrians that I think appreciated it, I hope. But if not, they will soon, because this song will probably be pretty popular. It definitely is a great encapsulation of kind of their trilogy, almost, between Family Ties, Range Brothers, and now this, of like them together joining forces and creating a really catchy, great popular song that happens to be hip-hop infused with some serious dance influence. Influenced also by Sticky, like I named earlier, even with kind of the way they rhyme, like that long A sound. Hey, yo, Eric, bring them girls to the stage, cause somebody's getting paid, and free big slime out the cage, and shorty try to play it cool, but in this, he's actually shouting out Messi and I think Neymar, saying Messi, get them girls off the stage, cause somebody's gonna get taken, somebody's gonna invade on a one-on-one conversation. I'm ducked off from the world, I'm immersed in the PlayStation, and I ain't worried about her, it's a thousand hers out waiting. Another cool thing worth including is the sample, Please Don't Live in Fear by Bon Iver, came out in like 2020, but you can kind of hear those lyrics and his voice come in and out of the production there, which is pretty cool. And I'm best dressed, moving forward, yeah, Tiny Tass on, yeah, all that, Compton Cowboy, all that. Kendrick's talking about himself being the Compton Cowboy, which is cool just because it's another example of how this like rodeo culture, I think a lot of it started with like stuff that Kanye was doing when he was out living in Wyoming, wearing a lot of like the Carhartt and Dickies and like really rugged outerwear, and also boots and all these kind of different things. And as you can see, Kendrick is wearing cowboy boots. I think they're snakeskin, alligator skin, something like that, with some jeans and even like what I think is a hat that may be the exact same one that Kanye was wearing for a while there, with like the red like stitched on letters on the brim, which is cool. Again, Baby Keem is doing really great on this record. A lot of really catchy kind of swings and bounces as he kind of moves through this song. The beat really doesn't change up a whole lot, which is interesting because like when I think of producing, I'm like, you know, you got to have all these different parts and like breaks and build ups, et cetera, et cetera. But as you saw with Just Wanna Rock, which is a little bit different. But when you see with a lot of these songs that offer like a freestyle kind of production where it's like we're just gonna play this beat, have a couple breaks and like stutters and a little bit different ideas, but for the most part the same, like 90% through, which is really cool because it really gives the artists a way to have consistency, but also their delivery be able to have a lot more attention towards it, and their lyrics and just the way they're rapping and performing, and especially in this music video, really cool. It's shot super low quality, like off of a VHS camera almost, like 360 pixels, like super like bare bones. But when you have individuals such as Kendrick Lamar and Baby Keem and Tyler the Creator, and you have but the director and the producer and the videographers, it really gives them a new avenue as far as how they can produce videos by going back in time, but also releasing and coming out with this really new sound. And it's not like it's never been done before kind of thing, but it's this really cool fusion of this kind of West Coast style delivery, and also it's not even that, it's just like I personally love dance music, I personally love hip-hop, those are like definitely my most to listen to genres. So to see one of my favorites and most listened to artists in the past couple years, Baby Keem, be able to get on a beat like this with Kendrick, who I believe is his uncle, it's really cool. So I definitely think y'all should go check that out. The Hillbillies, what a name. I mean, just oxymorons all over the place, which I think is just another little Easter egg, a part of this entire, you know, project in there. The way they've released and came out with their projects in the past couple years and the songs they've done in collaboration.
Yeah, big protein, 150 grams of protein. Y'all gotta stop playing, bro, I swear.
I couldn't help but talk about the 150 grams of protein that Kendrick must be consuming right now. It's funny, you hear that all the time from the trainers, like, eat your body weight in protein or even half of that. In grams, goodness. Pretty funny coming from the man himself. Yeah, maybe something to look into, folks.
Other than that, really great new song. Definitely check it out. The video's dope. The beat's dope. The lyrics are great. Shout out Messi and Neymar. They shout out Messi and Neymar, which is super cool. And it's just this fusion of like these metaphors and these ideas and these subjects and these styles and this production that you'd never think you'd see on one, which is really cool. And we definitely need more of that. And it keeps hip hop interesting. These kind of new production styles, especially with a lot of this like Jersey Club and like these really great dance beats being introduced back into like mainstream hip hop, is really exciting. Also with pop music as well. So definitely something to kind of keep your eyes and ears tuned for, because it's a lot to make of this, and hopefully we can expect a lot more great music like this from them very soon. So if you liked what we did today, just send it to one person, that's it. You know, just maybe say, yo, what's up, new video, didn't know this dude was doing YouTube, he's got a couple good points. Yeah, peace and love.